welcome back. Somewhere around here you can see my last made video. Definitely check it out. And as you can see above, this is the gaming news update of this couple of weeks. And I do have to say that I actually made this video already two times. The first one was, I think, 15 minutes, and the other one was 22 minutes. That's definitely way, way too long. So hopefully I can shorten this up to at maximum like 8 or 7 minutes. Okay, so first up is that bad news. Ni No Kuni, the really amazing looking and hopefully also playing level 5 Japanese RPG for the PlayStation 3 is also on the DS, but slightly different. It's actually a big difference. But however, instead of 2012, it's coming out next year in both Japan, both Europe and United States. So it's bad news for this year, but definitely great news for next year. Also, I've seen a new trailer of Devil May Cry, and holy freaking shit, finally, thank you Ninja Theory, they totally ditched the Twilight Dante, and they just created a new Dante, a younger Dante. Yes, he doesn't have white hair, but who cares, his moves are pretty much the same, his attitude is the same, Devil May Cry is definitely back. This could be one of the few original Japanese developed games now being developed by a Western developer that actually succeeded, actually any good. So we'll definitely see about that. Also, particularly great news, One Piece Pirate Warriors, the Gundam style One Piece grand game, is coming to the West. It's coming to both Europe and America, but the freaking thing is, it's that they actually mentioned that it's downloadable pretty much only. And they say that they're discussing retailers and Sony for a digital release. So hopefully with retailers that they're also doing an unbox. But to be honest, on a Facebook page of Namco Bandai, they say PlayStation Network. That sucks. I mean, that's gonna suck a lot. Because I am really, really looking forward to this game. And is this game, again, will be downloadable only? Like, damn it, come on guys. But hopefully, fingers crossed, that it will also be on disc for either either Europe or America. Okay, a new Hatsune Miku game has been announced. And if you don't know what this type of games are, it's pretty much Guitar Hero, but then with like this robotic Japanese pop singing girl. Really, really popular in Japan. A couple of games on a PSP, one game on a 3DS, I mean one port for the PlayStation 3, and now the new game is coming for both the Vita this year and for the PlayStation 3 next year. Okay, speaking of original Japanese games now being developed by a Western developer, Lost Planet 3 has been announced, developing by Spark Unlimited, the developers of Call of Duty The Finest Hour. And to be, what I have seen is that definitely the game looks much better than Lost Planet 2. Hopefully the developers have played the first Lost Planet and the second one, and hopefully they will retain the Japanese feel of the game, because it definitely has a Japanese feel and the arcade style shooting. But we all know that the Western developers are the masters, they are the kings of shooting games, of shooting games. So if they can retain the Japanese touch and implant the Western shooting mechanic, then it would, could be a really, really great game. Atelier Ayesha has been announced for the PlayStation 3. It's a new Atelier game, has nothing to do with the Atelier Arland trilogy, that part 3 is coming this year, I think in like June or July, Atelier Mamuri. So the new game is coming out, it looks even better. They say they're gonna rebalance the turn-based system, and yeah, definitely really hyped for it. It's coming out this summer in Japan, hopefully next year in Europe and America. Then another announcement of a kind of a big RPG is Trails of Nayuta. It's for the PSP, it's an action RPG, and it has nothing to do with the Legend of Heroes series. It has nothing to do with the Legend of Heroes Trails series, like Trails in the Sky and then the other two games. It has nothing to do with them, so it's a totally new game. They only have Trails in it. But yeah, another PSP game. PSP is getting a lot of love, a lot of games lately, pretty much only for Japan. Nippon Ichi announced they are creating a new RPG for the 20th years anniversary of Nippon Ichi. It's been unveiled at the Dengeki PlayStation magazine from Japan, so most probably it will at least be a PlayStation platform. My bet is PlayStation 3, but maybe also the Vita. They also announced it in May, so next month, and they're gonna unveil another game they are working on. So two games for Nippon Ichi, always a good thing. Way of the Samurai 4 has been announced for the United States, and that's actually a good thing, but the bad thing is it's downloadable only. And Xseed, the publishers and localizers of E7 and Trails in the Sky also, and a lot of great limited edition box set games have announced that they're doing digital now. They're going to do the digital approach. Only a few games will be a physical release. Hopefully the entire company will fall to its knees and to make sure that they should have released it in on disc, in physical, on the box, because Way of the Samurai 4, you know, it's a big game, and they're definitely going to ask like $40 for it for nothing. Digital data for me is nothing. It's thin air. It's not in my hand. I cannot touch digital data. It's nothing. I pay for nothing. I can pretty much just download illegally the game and can still play it and don't have to spend $40 on it. And with a box, that's a definitely difference. But for all you import freaks and also the collectors, Rising Star Games is releasing Way of the Samurai 4 in Europe in disc on a box, so you can definitely just import it. But still pretty good news, I guess, for people that download only. Pretty stupid, but whatever. A new Hyper Dimension game has been announced. It's God Dimension Neptunia V, and V is for Victory or Victories, whatever it was. It's in the late 80s, with a different approach. I think it has the same goddesses, but with a different approach, of more like in a war scene this time. And it's developed for the PlayStation 3. So as you can see, a lot of PlayStation 3 RPGs are being announced. Also, I want to mention this, because Sony is not mentioning it, so I'm just doing it, that Resistance Burning Skies for the PlayStation Vita is coming out, I think, next month. I think they said May. So definitely look out for that. The gameplay looked really good. It's the first person shooter on a Vita, so I'm definitely really hyped for how it will play. And I cannot wait to play another Resistance. I love Resistance, even though it's, you know, we already know the outcome of the entire war, but whatever. Also, I want to talk about one thing, and that is something really important. A new localizing company has announced that they have a wardrobe. Really, they said it like that, a wardrobe of PlayStation portable Japanese RPGs that they want to localize for Europe and for America. Pretty much only for America, they said, but hey, you can import it. But the thing is, this is the thing. It's about Clash of Heroes 2, though, by the way. And P-Door, I have no idea why you are not making a video for it. They need $500,000 to make a physical release. They don't have the money to put it on a disc and make a limited edition bundle and put and, you know, release it on a physical disc. So the game will come, and all those other games, they will come, but downloadable only. But, you know, they're making the option of the players, of the fans, to donate money to them. And the coolest thing is that you can donate from up to $5 to even $10,000. Well, I donated $100, or pretty much paid for the limited edition game and a voucher code to actually download the game, and you get a limited edition poster or something with it. So that's definitely awesome. But if you donate $10,000, you can, they will actually pay you, they will pay you, they will of course arrange everything to go 3 days to the E3. How freaking awesome is that? So with hotel, with parties, with dinners, you are going to the biggest gaming convention in the world, the E3. How freaking awesome is that? But hey, you have to put up $10,000. But still, they need 500,000. It's only 14 days to go, and they only have $66,000. So do You know the math, we all know they're not gonna make it. So please share it with everyone you know. Make sure that the Kickstarter project for Clash of Heroes 2, and not only for that, but for all the other Japanese RPGs that they want to come over to the West, and they will do it, but only downloadable. But if we donate money now, and if we buy a limited edition bundles, they have enough money to do the next game also on disc. So definitely do it. It looks really awesome. Check out the link below. Click on the link. Put it on Facebook. Give it to everyone you know. We need to raise the money to have a digital and have a physical release, a really cool, amazing limited edition bundle. So this is all the news I want to talk about today. And definitely leave in the comments below what are your biggest news topics of this coming weeks. New game announcements or something else you're really excited for, or like, okay, that's pretty cool. I think that the Tales of Games developers are mentioning that, like, they are now focusing on Japanese gamers instead of focusing on selling as much products as they can in the West because it's failing. Hell yeah. Finally, some developer knows it. Of course it's failing. Western gamers just don't buy Japanese games in a huge amount. So that's really awesome news. So definitely check in, put it in the comments below what was your best news or announcements or whatever what of the coming weeks or the last weeks. And yeah, I'm also on, like I said, on Facebook. Facebook link is below. You can always chat with me. You can always ask questions for me. Definitely if you have questions, you can better ask it on Facebook than actually on YouTube, because I'm pretty much always on Facebook. Because I have a phone with Facebook, so I can always reply to your question, and when I'm online you can always chat with me. So definitely hit me up on Facebook, and I hope you like this video, and I'll definitely see you next time.